What up, everybody? Today's day 208, making Songbringer. Today I'm going to be working on the home scene. This thing is going to be when you first crash your bike at the very beginning of the game. There's going to be a little more intro that's actually you're going to see on the ship Songbringer about how you actually get down here to the planet. But I'm going to start with just this scene here where you've already crashed your bike, and then the player is going to be like, right in front of the bike on the ground, right on the, just like you just crashed your bike, you fell off, hit your head, knocked yourself out. And after a little bit, you're waking up and saying these first initial lines. So that's the goal for today, is just to do a little animation for Rock to wake up, get off the ground, and finish up some of this dialogue, and also work with the story system so that it all works well to do all those things. So one thing, for example, I've just noticed is that it doesn't do this second dialogue. Oh, because it's supposed to be called 1A. Okay, let's see that. 1A. Let's see if it does both those dialogues. No, yeah, it's not playing that second one. Story home 1A. This should be fine. What's up, Canada's amazing? Yo. What up, man? How you doing today? So I'm wondering why that's should be pushing back two dialogues. Let's see what it's actually pushing back. System. I'll just set it right there. Check out what's getting parsed. It's probably not parsing correctly. Either that or it's not running it correctly after it's parsed it. We'll see. All right, here we go. Here we go. We need to look at story nodes. And this first one is called home one, this is it right here. So we need to look at the actions. This thing, yeah, it's only got one action. Dialogue home one. So it didn't parse correctly. All right, well, now we just need to check on why it didn't parse correctly. Here's where it's parsing actions. Wait, oh. Ah, okay, so this needs a loop over all the all the siblings of this tree. And if there's a music one or a dialogue one, then we're pushing back actions. Yeah, so that way we can push back multiple dialogues. All right, so if the key for this sibling, is music, we're gonna push it back. Yo. So actually this is just sibling.getStir. I don't really need to do Let me just do this. We can now put this all nice and neat on one line. Done. Okay. Next one, if it has the dialogue. This is almost exactly like that one. So if we have the dialogue and it's got a size. Wow. These are very similar now. Let's do a const vector of strings that is action keys. So we can make this a little less redundant. This has now become redundant to do the exact same thing twice here. Doesn't like that. No, no, that wasn't it. Why don't you like this? What's wrong with you? Hey, what's up, Mars Power? Yo, 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 yo. What's up, man? What is wrong with this? Is that it? That wasn't it. What's this error? I don't get it. That works. You can't. Oh, that's weird. You just can't construct a vector string that way. That's weird. Nice, man. Happy Sunday. I think it's still Sunday for you, right? You're what, 9 hours ahead? Oh yeah. I think we're pretty much gonna have that every single time. So if the sibling.getKey is inside, minutes to go till Monday. Is it a holiday for you guys on Monday? We have a nice holiday here in the United States on Monday. It's called Labor Day. Labor Day, where everybody stops laboring. It's really great. So find is what we're looking for. Find input iterator. We're looking in action keys. .begin. Action keys. .end, looking for sibling.getKey. If that's not equal to actionKeys.end, then we can push back this action key. And this is checking that the sibling also has. And now that I've wrote it like that. Oh, you guys have the same holiday on May 1st? Crazy. Wow. Just call this I. Hey, what's up, A Noah? Today I'm working on dialogue for the very first scene. So I got this little start thing started where he starts like saying some stuff at the beginning. He's actually going to be laying on the ground, right? You crash your bike. He's laying on the ground and he goes, oh, my head. And then he picks himself up off the ground and says a few more lines, and that's kind of the intro for the game, except there's going to be a lot more, or not a lot more, but there's going to be one other little scene on Songbringer before the game starts. So yeah, this is sort of like the second scene of the game, But I don't want either of them to be too long. I've played a lot of games lately, and I've decided that I don't like extra long intros, especially for games that can be speed run like this one. That's a little more succinct. All right, well, let's see if that parse correctly now. We need to set a little breakpoint. Check this data. Check it. Check the basics before you freak out because you don't have the basics. I totally just realized this. I could go const auto right there. That's how I can make this const. That work? Home scene is just the very, I call it home because it's just the very first scene. Right? So there's a screen right here. This pink one is the home screen. So the home scene is the scene that plays on the home screen. That did work. Okay, cool. Const auto ref is what I meant. Yes. Oh, nice. Nice. No, there's no menus. Nope. It's this. It's just this. This thing right here. The scene that plays while this is going on. Yo, what's up, Lunar Melt? Have I seen the movie Sex Drive? No? Is it good? You recommend it? I definitely love my commie. I'll check it out. What up? Why wasn't this? Oh, Photoshop, you and your special rules. Think you're so special, don't you? Nice. I'm on it. I'm saving this on my desktop so I remember to watch it. At first, I was like, it's got to be comedy, but then I was like, what if it's sci-fi? What if there's a sexual drive that gets you into hyperlight or hyperspeed? That would be a crazy concept for a video game. Sex drive, the video game. It's sci-fi. Okay, so I'm parsing these story nodes, just making sure they, do their thing. Here, so this first story node should have two actions for now. Yeah, good. It's got dialogue home one and dialogue home 1A. Great. Yay. Okay, let's see this once again. He should do these one after the other. Nope, looks like he's now doing both of them at the same time. What's up with you? Okay, so well, at least it's doing both of them. But okay, so when it runs this, oh, okay, here's the problem. Dialogue key needs its own overall delay. That gets passed in. Well, I can start here. Duration is delay. There, that's what we need. Oh, that's why you say Sombria? Oh, nice. It totally rhymes. Rumspringa. Songbringa. Yes, there should be one bug here where it's not calling it correctly. So this is going to be timer. There. So now that should delay the actions one after the other. And then next we'll draw this little animation so he can get off the ground. He'll wake up. He'll wake up with a headache because he fell off his bike. Because he crashed his freaking bike into the planet. What an idiot. This is taking a while. Okay, this is taking a while to compile. I'll just get this animation. Started. We need sprites. Rock. So he's gonna get off the ground. What's a good? I guess his death animation is sort of similar. Which here, rock die. Without the sword, that one's the one we're gonna want. Yes. Okay, I'm noticing that, yes, I'm glad that those are actually going back to back. That's cool. When it does, switches characters, or when it does a single line, let's build this in here. So if duration is greater than zero, we're going to do duration plus 0.5. Otherwise, duration. So that way, after each dialogue key, there's a half second. And also in between each dialogue, we're going to put another half second down here, maybe a quarter. So it should be a little more delay between each, and then a little more, even more delay between each overall section of dialogue. I love not knowing what the heck he's saying, what Jib's saying. Oh, so great. He only hazard a guess. All right. I liked that, but I wanted to put Rock had two lines here that could be broken into. Into two lines. It's, you know, he doesn't say nonsense. Look, I'm actually written all his lines. So there's an item you'll be able to get which can translate Jib for you. So see, every time each one of these lines, Jib is actually saying something. Says Rock says, "What? Where am I?" Jib says, "This is the surface of planet Xera." And then Rock goes, "Let's explore." And Jib goes, "Does this mean you're going to eat all the cacti without thorough analysis?" Oh, yeah. What's up, Momir? Or E or. Okay, so yeah, we got those. Now let's do the animation. So we're gonna need an animation where he gets up off the ground. I got him laying on the ground right here, which is kind of like he looks almost dead. So do something like this, sort of in reverse. Call this rock. Wake up. Wake up. Okay, I'm gonna crack out my graphics tablet. Do some art here. Make him animate, and then so this will be all gonna be kind of complete, right? The scene. He starts off on the ground. He gets up, says some lines and stuff. It's a proper video game now. Let's see what that looks like in reverse. My God, that's so funny. I want to try it in the game right away. Oh, I know I'm not going to end up with this animation, but I just want to see what it looks like because it's so hilarious. Okay, we're going to put this in the rock folder. Where'd it go? Sheets. Oh, is it in Heroes now? Did I move it? Oh, it's in Heroes. Wake up. Wake up. What's up, Azarus? What does home scene mean? This is crazy. I don't know. You're the second person to ask. I thought it was clear. It's just the scene that runs on the home screen. So that's what I'm working on here. What's up, Alex Pita? All right, I'm gonna try it right now. Let's see. Let's see it again. Whoop. Whoop. Oh, it's so great. All right, well, now we just need to get it to run that, right? So animate. We got a call to animate wake up. Oh, we need to animate, we need to know what character. So animate rocks, wake up. Yeah, that'll be fine. Rock, wake up. All right, so we need to be able to run this now and add it into this whole story system. So Matrix Bringer, yes, that's what that is. Matrix Bringer. Yep. That's right, I did. I only know one emote. I'm using it every day from now on. Forever. That's kind of a bold claim. I'm not sure if I could back that up. All right, so yeah, first thing we need to be able to process or parse the animation call. So let's add it to the action keys. That's right. BC Warrior. This one's good too. Okay, so animate, it should just pass back a string. Yeah, that should work. Let's see. I always say that should work, and I never know if it does. So let's check if that worked, and then we'll get it to actually process that and do that. Yo, what's up, Jonah19? Yeah, I've been working on dialogue and story a lot. You'll see. I'm working on the dialogue for the home screen. It's the home scene. It's the scene that runs when you crash your bike. Or it's after you've crashed your bike, you pick yourself up off the ground and say a few lines. Okay, let's see if that worked there. Hello, the Fearless Hyena. Such a cool name, man. Did I say Pizza Warrior? No, BC. BC. Or before Christ, yeah. Oh, is this what this guy is? This really BC, as in ancient? I thought he was BC, like for British Columbia. PC Warrior. All right, so I'm checking if this parsed correctly. Story node should have three actions. Yeah, cool. We got dialogue home one, animate rock, blah, 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 dialogue home 1A. Cool. So we've successfully parsed. Now we need to get it to run this animation. Oh, I think it's BC as in British Columbia, because Canada is amazing shared it with me yesterday. Yes, everyone in British Columbia looks like that guy. No, but really, they do got these mustaches sometimes. People in BC are awesome. I love you, BC people. We just went up there a couple months ago, back in July. So we need an animes animate. Let's call it story in him. Float story in him. We need a const string ref of anims and a float delay before it all runs, and then we're going to return a duration of the whole animation. The duration of the animation. I do have a mustache, that's right. That's Pizza Bringer, huh? Yeah. Hell yeah. Who wouldn't? Who wouldn't? Right, Boogie? Oh, yeah, really? Where's my pink? I don't have a pink wig, but I do have sunglasses. Okay, so I have to make it my mission to find a pink wig so I can be the BC Warrior. And I'll have to shave my beard. Anims, dialogue, here we go. So we're gonna go. Let's make a little function that extracts character names. It'll return a string. Ooh, caps lock. String get character name from a string. Is that all it needs to do? Oh yeah, we want to, this is a modify, so we want to go string ref stir. Your character name. Pause equals start out fine, blah. Pause equals blah, blah, blah. Return a blank string. Otherwise, return this character name. Let's call it character name. And modify this there. Oh, no, this should be called extract character name. Because it's modifying the string. And then we'll return character name. Appall for PG names? What? What's that? Appall? Poll? Poll? For PG names? What? Oh, no way. Really? That's no explanation. Oh, here. BC Warrior stands for BC Warrior. What the hell? That doesn't help either. Oh. This website's fail. Fail website. Was it down farther? Did I miss it? I don't know. Totally. It explains everything. I don't even need to know anything else. Forever and ever and ever. Character name, extract. Oh, no worries, man. No worries, no worries, no worries. Extract character name from text. Beep. There. So, I guess the first thing we should do is make sure that still works. And we do need to create this method, story anim. I love you guys. And this is the new one. He's probably driving. What's up, Absent Mind? Yeah, I love my Mac. It's so great. And it only costs $1,000. Macs have really, really gotten cheaper over the years. Okay, good. So all I wanted to check there was that it was actually attributing the right dialogue to the right characters. So now we can go and parse this story in M thing. So we'll call this. Whoops. What's up, Absent Mind? What's up, Kratchen? Greetings. All right, so let's parse out. We'll go string anims, anims. No. We want to do a vector of strings, words, split anims by delimiter space into words, and then we'll parse out each one of these animations here. Oh yeah, I hear you, man. I had the same thing my last whole video game. I had to develop on an 8-year-old laptop. This thing is ancient, man. Look at this. This Mac actually got me through developing all of Hero Bash, this last video game. This thing couldn't even run Xcode 5 when it came out because it was so old. But I freaking made it work, man. Right? Yeah, I know that feeling. Oh, really? Oh, Lunar Melt, man. Nice insight. Nice insight. You know what? We don't need to do this. We don't need to parse it into separate words because we can do different NMs. So if we wanted to do two NMs, we could just do an animate this guy, animate that guy. So yeah, so we just need to do a string NM key NMs and then auto character name equals extract character name from NM key, and then we can find the actual character and all that. Yes, yeah, I'm standing. Yes, I am. Huh. All right, next we need another little reusable method. We need to be able to find an entity by their name. Oh man, that's just too simple. Okay, so now we got the character. Yeah, wow. It's less fun than now. Oh man. Yeah. Oh yeah. Yeah, I hear you. That's the nice thing about web dev. You can do it anywhere. I mean, on like any kind of computer. Okay, so now we're gonna just run this character's animation. So yeah, well, let's get the animation. So autoNM equals E dot profile dot profile.get animation for key. Doesn't matter skin. We're just looking for NM key. So this is going to be run the animation. What's up, Runic LP? What that means is it's accessing a pointer. There's some really, really weird noises outside. Yes, yeah, that's right. That's right. You put two colons between your class name and your function or method name. You can also do member names this way as well. Or you can call superclass methods that way as well. This means you're accessing a pointer. So if I had a pointer to something like a sprite. Let's say I had auto sprite pointer equals new sprite. Then to access a member or a method of sprite pointer, I would use this. And that's, it's not the dereference operator. I forget what is this operator called? Can someone please help me? I forget what this operator is called. But there, so that's how I would access it, right? And I could do the same thing if I had a member called X or whatever that was accessible in public. I could access it like that. But if this were not a sprite, or if this were not a pointer, right? If it were just a regular class or structure, structures are classes, I could just do sprite S dot sort all children. And I would do S dot X to access that member, if that was a member. Does that help you, Runic LP? These are two methods for accessing something. This is not a pointer, so we're using the dot notation. This is a pointer, so we're using this minus sign thingy. Oh yeah, and you can use it to call static functions. Me too, fearless hyena. But you're fearless, man. What do you mean? I thought you were fearless. So if this animation is not equal to null pointer, we can run it. So we're gonna go e.render.setAnimation. Whatever this animation is, an M key. Repeat 0 times. Afterwards, we're gonna run idle forever. And then we also need to add to the duration. So we're gonna need a float duration equals delay. And then duration plus equals nm get, I think it's just get duration, yeah. Get duration, return duration. One last thing, we need to make sure that we delay by the overall delay. Oh, they call it structured dereference. Oh, thanks, Momir. What's up, member 7? Are you joking? I know, right? I know. I'm not fearless. Not entirely. Okay, I'm totally fearless of everything. I'm not afraid of spiders. Not at all. No. Not, especially not giant spiders. Those are totally friendly. I can stick my hand right in a giant spider's mouth. No problem. Oh, nice, man. Nice. Thank you. That's a nice compliment. So technically, we need to run e.render.sprite.schedule. We're gonna schedule once. We need to pass in the id. Delay is duration, key is story name. Oh man, I don't like this anymore. I don't like this schedule once because this could now overwrite. Oh, you don't do birthday parties anymore? Oh. What's up, Achillium? Run action, this is the better way to do it because that this isn't gonna overwrite. Create, we'll delay some time. Of duration. And then run the action. Call func. Create. Pass in id. And then we need to get this system in. Or not. Well, let's just do entity. We'll just get that one entity's component. So entity get render component dot set animation. Oh, we need to pass in the nm key as well. What? This is really weird. Oh, entity get. Oh. That's what I get for not letting the autocomplete complete stuff for me. All right, man. Good night, dude. Thank you. Yeah, thanks, Azimuth. All right, let's see if that worked. That should... Oh, we need to hook up the story name call first. So we need to be able to call this when we're running actions. Paired up first is... Animate. Timer plus equals... story name. Let's see. See if it works. So this is going to be funny because this is an animation I just did by reversing the death animation. This is actually supposed to be him on the ground, and he just gets up. But this is going to be kind of funny, hopefully. What happened? Oh, okay, so it totally delayed the whole time. Something went wrong. Oh. Yo, what's up, Hyrule Spy? It's going great, man. I'm working on dialogue and story elements and stuff. Okay, well, I guess stepping into here would be the first thing to do, just to see what's going on with that method. Especially with the timer already, we'll have to see what that all computes out to. Yeah, thanks, man. Yeah, it's getting there, right? Every day gets a little bit better. The whole game gets a little bit better. I'm a very incremental. I make incremental progress. That's the only way I know to make something cool, is just to make little changes every day until it gets cooler and cooler and cooler, until one day it's like ice. It's like a toilet seat in the Yukon. All right, so we're starting this off with a delay of 10.6 seconds. That's the time for them to run all of their dialogue. So let's see how this works out. We got a character name of Rock, cool. Anim key, wake up. Oh, did I hook up the wake up anim? Is that what happened? I don't think I did this yet. Oh, duh. Okay, so Rock. We need a wake up in him. This character has so many animations already. This is just called wake up. Format Rock. Wake up, beast. All right, let's cross our fingers and hope this works. Oh, we don't need this here. Oh my God, that's so funny. But why is it delaying so long? Oh, I know. Okay, it's delaying the entire time again after it does this, so this shouldn't return. Yeah, this should, float duration should be 0. And then, right? Yeah. Now if I can just get him to start on the ground, which might have to be kind of like a little custom case type thing. Oh, here, we just need to delay the delay, but return only the duration. Nick attempts the moonwalk, sure. Right? Let's see what it looks like. Now that it's the timing should be about right. We might need to add a half second actually to the duration. All right, cool. That's so funny. Okay, next step. He's really got to start on the ground for this whole thing to work. So we need to do some... I think this needs to be a special case because the story elements don't run until after the whole... the opening curtains type of effect. So when we create Rock's hero element, if they're on the home screen and we haven't done the action for... is this right? Maybe that, there might be a better way to do this actually. Yeah, I might as well do this the right way, right? No, let's do this the wrong way first. I'm going to do it the wrong way first just to see what it looks like. And then I can do it the right way. So when it actually creates the player, create heroes and all this. I think I need to actually do it in load game. The Dizzy shader? Yeah. A little bit. So we've created the world, we've created the heroes, we've loaded the game. Yeah, it definitely needs to happen in load game. So we've got the player's entity. Loaded possessions, position, story, everything. Set story data. If the current position, so world, get pause. Pretty sure I set the pause. Yeah, I did a world set pause up here once it loaded the player's current position. So we'll check if we're on the home screen by doing if world get pause equals world get start pause for 0, which is the overworld. And we haven't already done home one. Render. Dot sprite dot now e dot render dot set animation. We'll do lying down, repeat, zero, never repeat this. So he's just laying down there forever until something else triggers him. So we need the lying down animation, which will have one frame. What's up, Ethan? Cool, man. Good for you. Wake up, East. This is like zero, the very first frame. Okay, let's see if this works. No? Oh, man. Something went wrong. Something went wrong. Oh, thanks, Limp and Zen. Cool, man. Right on, man. Good for you, making music. Okay, let's figure out what happened. Why didn't it do this? Or maybe it did. Maybe it did and it overrode things. Let's try this. E dot render dot flags. So it'll make the animation no longer overwritable. Maybe that was it. It might have like run something else. Yeah, the audio visualizer is cool, man. What's going on? I don't know what's going on. Oh, I just realized what's going on. Okay, I deleted these flags wrong. And equals. Still on the ground, what's up? Moonwalking, was he? He's sort of walking on the moon a little bit. All right, so this is what I'm trying to do. This is, might be somewhere. Oh man, I don't know where. Yeah, Ethan, I kind of like other kind of music without Before on the Floor myself. But you know, that's everybody's individual preference, right? Your own aesthetic. Your aesthetic for music is different than my aesthetic, so we like different things. Yes. Bring it. Bring the bringers. Alright, I'm gonna try an experiment here. If I do this. Wait, does it even get here? Let's try it. Let's see if it even does that. Yeah, okay, it's doing this. Um try this again somewhere else. Totally. It's not that it's I'm not saying your music's bad or that it needs to be better. I'm just saying that I personally prefer other types of music. So I have a hard time judging the quality of music I don't like because inherently I don't like it. So, you know, that's just not my aesthetic. So sorry, but I can't really give you any feedback on it. What's up, Arcane? I'm working on dialogue here. So we got this whole scene working where all I want now is to get the player to start on the ground. But what he's supposed to do is he's supposed to start laying flat on the ground like he just fell off his bike. And then he does these initial dialogue lines. And then he gets up off the ground. So that's the goal for this little sequence. I'm going to do that Mars Power right before I release the Advanced Alpha. So probably, I'm thinking the Advanced Alpha is going to be like sometime between the 20th and the 30th of this month. And I'll definitely be sending it to you and to Alex Pita before that so you guys can see if those bugs still exist. So I'll do playthroughs of the Advanced Alpha same time, right before I'm releasing it. So probably like the 20th or the 25th or something like that. I know there's no time. Totally. Yeah, of course. Totally. Okay, I'm trying an experiment here. Instead of starting on the ground here, let's start on the ground. Inside the story system. Yeah, Big Beast, there's lots of it already, but I could play some right now if you guys want to see the actual game. It's okay, let's just try doing it here. Let's see if we hit this, how many times we hit this too. Okay, so let me just see if this works. Advertisements. YouTube. Oh, YouTube, why do you gotta kill us with advertisements? Force us to watch these things. God, I wish you could just turn off all the ads. Yeah, there's so many good swords. All right, cool. Yeah, I'll play the game a little bit first for you guys. No, wait. I want to run. Okay, so I ran this once, twice, a few times I made it. Oh man, it's just running forever. There. All right, okay, it ran it a bunch, but there, at least we started on the ground that time. I love that. Oh, God, I love seeing that. All right, so this is what the game looks like, right? It's like Zelda 1, but it's completely procedurally generated. So you enter 6 letters when you start the game, and it generates an entire world based on those 6 letters. This is the room where you find the sword, right? You get it in here, and you can, like, it's kind of a moment. You pick up the sword, it's all epic. There's all this music and stuff. But yeah, so this is like a Zelda 1 where it's got an overworld. This is the lightning sword. You have several different kind of ghost swords. These ghost swords work with your existing sword to create a projectile. So the projectile I have right here is the lightning sword projectile, which hits an enemy. The lightning strikes the enemy, and then it also strikes another random place on the screen, so there's a chance you can even get hit with your own lightning. There's a fire sword, there's lightning sword, there's an ice sword, there's a fear sword. So there's levels as well as this overworld, and there's tons of different area styles as well. So this is like the green forest area. Here's more like of a dark forest area. What's this? Some level. So yeah, here's where you can like take these elevators up or down into these levels. And yeah, this is it. It's like playing Zelda 1, but it's more modern, basically. And you can see secret walls, too. So you can got these cactuses, and you eat these cactuses. And yeah, this allows you to see secret walls. I just realized I can't play this music. Copyrighted music, right? I mean, I'll definitely check it out later. Oh, it's probably ruined my video. Damn. Really? Chrome plus Adblock? You thought Americans love ads? Not this one. I hate ads. Adblock? I've never heard of this. Oh, dude. Holy crap. Oh, thank you, Marza. There's also uBlock, huh? I know. Oh, God, right? Oh, yeah. I mean, it's a great song. You want the beer sword? yeah, YouTube notices anyways, man. I even have recorded, I've played music from my phone, right? And it was recording from my laptop. So that's a horrible quality, right? But it, yeah, my YouTube still triggers my videos. So whatever. It's all right. No, I've never heard of Adblock. Can you believe that? Dude. Yeah, yeah. Oh, no, wait. No worries, man. No worries. Yeah, yeah. So, yeah, I put every one of these days' videos on YouTube. So if anybody's interested, you can go all the way back to day one when all I had was a brown screen. So every day is there and documented on YouTube. You can watch it forever. Ah. Oh, well, that's good. Hopefully. Okay, so back to working on this initial scene here. This is a totally janky thing to do right here. But it might be necessary. If I do this, I want to see if this works if I do it only once. Actually, let's verify that it does work. without the debug break. What's up, Big Beast? I'm programming on Xcode in on a Mac. Programming in a language called C++, and I'm using a game library slash game engine called Cocos2DX. This game is going to be cross-platform. It's coming out for Windows, Mac, Linux, all of that, and iOS, RetroVGS, possibly PlayStation and Xbox One if I can get the funds. And yeah, I definitely recommend using a cross-platform game engine to anyone doing game development. I know I was doing that last night. Oh, because it saved my story. So let's turn off the fact that we did the home one part of the story. NES and Atari, that would be such a challenge. Right, trying to get all these 32-bit graphics to be all 8-bit. Yay, there he's laying on the ground. Okay, let's see if we do the system. If we do this only once, if this is going to happen only once, we'll just use a static variable, do it janky way. So I'm just testing if this works, if I run that animation only once, if he'll actually be lying down. Because this is a complex system as far as how the rendering goes, and sometimes it runs certain animations, and sometimes it does, it tries to make sure that the player does his idle animation. Oh, that does work. Oh, nice. So we can create a story node entity which will start the player on the ground. Yeah, okay, so let's do this. The story node entity is going to look like this. Let's write the story first. Just divide the graphics by four. Oh my God, if only it were that simple. We'll call this one home zero. Only triggers at the home screen. And we want to animate rocks lying down. So I need some way to specify that this is basically, I want to be able to say the repeat is zero and the next animation is nothing. So he continues laying down forever. Oh, is it? No, I believe it's a lot more complex than that because of everything else, not just graphics, but memory. There's so much stuff in memory that I use, right, to create this procedural world. And the NES is limited, it's RAM. Very, very limited RAM. So, and music. All your music is only five channels, sort of MIDI-ish. So, it's not very simple to port this game to NES. Okay, how do I do this? How do I specify that I want rocks lying down animation and the next animation? Oh, just make a 2x2 maze? One day. Okay, I guess we'll have to do we have to make this whole animate thing a little more flexible in how this runs this whole system. So animate should be, we'll start with the character, right? We're doing the character rock. He's lying down. We run that 0 times and nothing else. And then this one will be rock, wake up 0 times, and then run idle forever. Yeah, so we need to, now we just need to parse the animations better. Right, and then a year later, it's finished. All right, parsing's fine. Now we just need to do when it actually does enims story enim. Man, I've been mousing with my graphics tablet the whole time. No, it's not. The drawback to JSON is that you can't order your data. So, and it's wordier. Oh my God, it's so much wordier, dude. Yeah, so for example, in my data files, I have behaviors, and all the behaviors, well, this is a bad one because he doesn't have any behaviors, but fly, for example, has a behavior. And these need to be guaranteed to come in order. So, and also JSON is just way too wordy, dude. You have to like do this and s put quotes around stuff, then put a colon, then put some other stuff. And put a semicolon, put another brace. Look at all that BS I have to type. It's so much easier to use this. I published this, but it's called Valtry, GitHub, NatWeese, Valtry. But that's not guaranteed. I was trying to use it the other day when I wrote the behavior trees. This is a long time. This was months ago, so maybe the newest Cocoa CX is different. But months ago, I did that, and I started with JSON, and during the live stream, we all realized that, oh my God, JSON is not reading the data in the right order. So I wrote my own thing anyways for it. Besides, it's just too wordy. There's too many quotes, too many braces, too much stuff to put in there. Right, cool. So we'll go character name. Extract character name. We're not gonna use that anymore. So we need to extract into words. Vector string words. Split. We'll split it all up by spaces into words. Character name is going to be the very first word. Words.size less than or equal to 0. Return 0. Character name is going to be the first word, so we'll go words 0. YAML, huh? I haven't heard of YAML before. Or I have heard of it, I've just never seen it. Yay, Malay markup language. Cool, nice. I like this. I like that they're doing it like that. No, there's no quotes around stuff. There's no braces. That's cool. I like it. Oh, wow, I could have used YAML. Nice. Well, I already wrote my own thing. Right, so we're gonna parse. We got the first word is a character name. The next word is the animations. So an M key is going to be the second word. So we're just going to go ahead and pass in words. So if words dot size is greater than or equal to well, one would be the first character's name, two, three. So if it's greater than three, then we're gonna run this. Words one is the NM key. So actually we need to do greater than or equal to five for this one. So words one, we'll do str 2l, words two dot c str. Oh, we need to parse actually an integer for this. Mars is time traveling again. What's up, Arcor? Yo, man. Welcome to the stream. I'm working on dialogue today for the home screen where you wake up from having crashed your bike. So I'm working on a little bit of a more of the story system where the player is going to start himself lying down. So I've got these anim keys where I can run animations, and now I've made them really flexible so I can specify the character name, the animation to run, the amount to repeat the animation, the next animation to run, and the amount to repeat the next animation. So I'm working on that, parsing that, and then it'll be able to have the player actually start on the ground and be doing it right. Words two dot sister. I get it because I said C string. Nice. You're doing assembly today? Crazy cool. Good for you, man. Oh, that's a real programmer right there. Assembly. What were you doing today? Oh, I had assembly for breakfast. Wait a minute. I either need to parse forever. Do I already have the word forever parsed somewhere? I'm not sure if I do. I have it in K behavior forever. Whoa, for Ness? Nice. You won't be able to, yeah, you're gonna have to write your own sister method. Nazim. There's a Nisazim. There's a new Nazim called Nisazim. Oh, Nesazim. Oh, cool, dude. So, well, I mean, we could do repeat one is words two equals forever. Yeah, no, let's parse, let's write a function called parse, blah, blah, blah. Auto parse repeat equals this, and we'll yeah, I guess we'll just do words. We'll capture words by reference. And then we'll do an integer. I will be the element that we're accessing. So if words.size is less, no, if I is less than words.size. Or if I is greater than or equal to words.size, return 0. Otherwise, we'll do like the other thing. Ghostman, what's up? Welcome to the stream, Ghostman. I know this probably looks complicated right now, but so is flying a plane. And so is driving a car. So it's a lot like driving a car. At first, everything looks really complicated. You have no idea what to do. But give it some time, and it all starts to clarify and make sense. Yeah, definitely. Compared to assembly, this is really, really simple stuff. Yeah. And Ghostman, another thing that I recommend doing is watching streams like this, or also watching things done fast in time lapse, for example. You can watch somebody code something in time lapse, and you kind of get a subconscious overview of the process one is using to create games. It's the same thing for just watching these streams or a stream like this. Even though you don't know what the heck is going on, or you don't know what is being coded or whatever, or you don't know how the art is actually being outputted or whatever, it doesn't matter because you're kind of subconsciously absorbing what's going on. And give it enough time and you'll start to absorb the process, and subconsciously you'll kind of know how to do games. You'll subconsciously have a clue for where to start with video game development. What's up, Bar Games? Right? Nice, right on. What's up, Edge P? Yeah, there you go. Yeah. What's something I've done for Sombre that I really love how it turned out? Oh, everything lately. The fire sword's pretty dope. Let me show you the fire sword. The waterfalls are neat. I'll go to a waterfall and I'll show you the water, and that's the fire sword. So this is something I love, these waterfalls. And there's a secret behind here. I'm not going to say what it is, but there's a secret back there. But yeah, here's the fire sword. I need to work on the graphics for it. I need to make it look more like a fireball. But it's so cool because it lights up a fire where the enemy gets hit, right? And you can even be hit by your own fire. So if I go over here, I can get hit by my own fire. Dude, that just worked them all because they got stuck in the fire. So yeah, you can get hit with your own fire, so you got to be careful with it. But yeah, I love this fire sword. Oh, I can't use it because I don't have health. I'm out of health. But yeah, I love that. Those two things are cool. Cool. Oh yeah, this one's great. I love it. Yeah, he kind of does some coding in this too, right? I don't know. But I got some on mine too. YouTube, C, NetWeese. So I got all my song. Whoops. All of Songbringer has been speed time lapsed. There you go, speed game development. Oh. Yeah, it's for some people, it's not for some people. Unity is actually a really powerful, awesome tool. But yeah, it's for some people, not for others. What's up, Light of Thief? Yo, yo, man. I'm working on plot, story elements, trying to get it so it can actually parse this one story element right here where the player is going to start lying on the ground. Okay, so back to here in IMS, we need a function which parses repeat. So if words I equals forever s, return k forever. Otherwise, return str 2l words I dot c str null pointer int 10. There, so now we got a function which can parse anything's repeat based on the words. What? What's wrong with this? Why isn't it like this? Return type long must match previous return type int. Oh. Okay, compiler. Lambdas. What's up, Adon? Yo! Yes, exactly, the plot thickens. Adon, man, oh, it's been forever. I hope you've been good. Oh, what's up? I haven't seen you since like March or something. All right, Ghostman, good night. They're making you use Alice? What's that? It's not, it's a programming environment for 3D. Oh. Huh. Oh, right, here's the Alice programming language. Fun fib 0 equals 0, or fib 1 equals 1, or. I'm reading that as or, but it's probably not or. Right? Oh no, dude, you've been busy. Okay, so let's parse these words out. Repeat one is parse repeat. We're gonna pass in, we already got words, so we need to pass in index 3. And then repeat two is parse repeat 5. There, so we got words one, and this is repeat one. And then the next animation is going to be words three. Oh, so that means that we need these parse repeats need to be two and four. And then this is repeat two. And then else. Set animation, blah, 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 blah. We're only doing that. We want to do, yeah, nothing here. Wow, you drag and drop everything. Did I see the messages about Fmod? No, what's that? And welcome to the stream, what's this so? Fmod. Ooh, it's so colorful. It's sort of like Unity, but for kids. So I get the feeling that it's like Unity for kids. Oh, man. Yeah, right on. Good for you. Your son's a year and a half now. Right on. Oh, all right. Cool. I didn't even know I had a Twitch inbox. Sorry about that. I've never checked it. So pardon me if I haven't checked that. I'll try and remember to do that tonight. Oh, I gotta pass in parse repeat here. All right, and I need to set a breakpoint here to make sure that works. And then I also need to turn off the system for doing this whole jankiness here. So if the goal for all of this is to get it so so that's going to make him, we need to do if the action is a dialogue. So if I wish there were a nice way to write this. Whoa. Oh, nice. Oh, cool. This is so nice. Thank you, man. So we need to do, let's just do this the janky way. So bool. So we're gonna go loop over each pair in the node.actions. And if pair.first equals dialogue, and I guess we can go if flux is fluxing. Then can during flux, let's just go can equals false, and we can break out of this loop. And then if not can, continue this overall loop. So basically that's gonna make it so it allows story elements to run all the time, but it doesn't allow story elements to run that have dialogue during a flux. So let's see if that works. See what the heck happens here. Make sure this breakpoint's on. Marza, good night. Good night, Marza. What's up, Panda? Small cat won't get fined. Let's hope. Here's the hoping. Oh man, it didn't even trigger that. Why didn't it trigger that? Okay, let's make sure it's got that in him. Yeah, this is all good. Set another breakpoint up here where it splits the words in the story name. This should work. What's up? Story home zero flags home. That's gonna be fine. Animate rock lying down zero. Whoa, nice. There we go. Okay, now it's triggering this story name, so it must not have got in. Cool. I gotta check his timeouts out later. You, the floaty guy, Jib, yeah. They're talking now. Everybody talks. Jib talks, but you can't understand him. But he does have lines that have actually been written for him. Words, here we go. Words, what's this turn out to be? Good, we got three words. That's what this is intended. Rock lying down zero. Okay. We should be able to find rock. Good, we got the rock's entity, duration, and him. Oh, it doesn't have the lying down in him? Did I not write? I thought I wrote that. Rock. Lying down. What the hell? All right, I guess we gotta try that again. All right, so duration, anim. Here, we gotta step into this one because it's failing. Key is gonna be a what? Obviously, an M key is nothing. Oh, duh. Cool. I'm glad this wasn't as hard as I thought. Let's just verify that it has words zero. The lower right of the game. The lower right is the health. The lower left is the map for the overworld. So, yeah, it's you also got this map in your actual inventory. You have a map of everything. What's up, Voice of Grog? Yo, man, it's going great. I'm working on animations now for the story. Oh, it's gone. What's up, Gaming Universe 101? I'm great. How are you doing? Right, Momir, good night, man. Oh, here? Yeah, this is the overworld. This is just an output of the overworld. So you generate the overworld with your world seed. This is world seed Dingle, right? And this is just a map in the code of showing some stuff like here's the home screen, here's a store, here's a secret, here's a refill, here's level two, you know. And then also I have a thing that can output these maps. So this is actually the map for this world, Dingle, and that this pink screen is your home screen. Here's like one of the levels. Here's another level. Here's a desert area. This green area here is forest. This brown area is mountains. These darker green areas are like a dark, creepy forest. This is the sea. These are some lakes. Here's some rivers. These overworlds are looking good. Yeah, I know. I noticed that too. The dialogue is going behind stuff, and it really, I guess it shouldn't ever go behind stuff. So I think I'm going to use a global Z order. I'm going to write this down so I don't forget. There's two ways I could do that. I could use global Z, or I would have to detach it from the actual entity of that it's attached to. So, one of those two. It does look like molecules, right? Yeah, right? You're like, move EAX 3. All right, so for each one of these animations, it needs to add based on the repeat count. Okay, so we can just. Let's parse everything before we actually even get into this method. So we'll go parse repeat one and two. We'll go string nm1 equals words one, two. Words one, rock, look, yeah, word one. And then we're gonna parse out the duration of everything before we do any of this. Yes, yeah, he still has his top hat. You can throw it. Yep. I'm gonna probably change his hair color though, because it's too close to the color of the hat. All right, M1 is words one, but this is only if words dot size is greater than or equal to is greater than one, right? Zero. Greater than, let's just go greater than or equal to two. Words.size needs to at least be two, which is the character name and one of their animations to run. So that guarantees us that we can parse these repeats and we can get NM1. Nice, I heard that one's great. And M2 equals words dot size is greater than or equal to four. One, two, three, four. Yeah, four. Then we'll use words three. Otherwise, it's just nothing. Now we'll loop over each one of the animations, adding the duration up. So actually, no, we just want to add the duration for the first one. So in M1, if NM is not equal to null pointer, multiply this possibly by repeat one. If repeat one is greater than one or is greater than zero, then we're gonna go repeat one minus one, otherwise multiply by one. Is that right? No, that's not right. Yeah, that's right. There we go. Good night, Ladder Thief. Cheers, man. Okay, let me think. Let's look at this. Like, the duration of the animation is the anim's duration times, if repeat one is, say, one, if you're going to repeat it once, then it's going to be repeat one times that. Yeah, so that would be, no, this is plus one. So if we're repeating once, then we need to add, multiply by two. Yeah, and if we're repeating zero or below, we're only doing the duration times one. Okay, cool. Nice, XY Storm. Cool, man. It's fun. It's so fun and easy. I mean, I guess it's not easy, but it is very, very fun. Repeat one, repeat two, NM1, NM2. Now, if nm2.size, then we're going to run nm1, repeat 1, nm2, repeat 2. Otherwise, we're just running nm1, repeat 1. Okay, that was a lot of work there, but let's get this, let's make sure this is all working. Right? Who doesn't want to be a ninja? Well, I guess there's probably people out there that don't want to be a ninja, but screw them. All right, let's see if this works. We're going to go just test this method out. So we're triggering the story animation. The string we have passed in here is rock lying down space zero. So that's going to give us three words. Yeah, da da da. Ninja or pirate, depending on the day of the week. I hear ya. What kind of mood are you in? So right now you're in ninja mode, huh? Let's make sure these came out correct. Repeat one. Zero, good. Repeat two, zero. And M1, lying down, and M2, blank. Good, good, good. Now, the duration should be zero to start, and then we add in that animation's duration, which is 0.1. Yeah, that's correct. Okay, this should work. Let's check the other one too. Yeah, XY Storm is a C++. Thanks, Arcore. All right, so this animation is a little bit different. We got Rock, wake up, Zero, idle forever. So he's got a second animation he's supposed to run afterwards. So make sure this parses as well, and also his duration parses correctly. So repeat one, repeat two. This is zero, repeat two is negative one. Good, that's forever. And then we got wake up and idle. Cool. And then the duration of all this should be the length of the wake up NM, which just turns out to be 1.4 seconds. I think this is working. Let's see. If this works, then we'll have the player laying on the ground to start with. Man, it's been like a long time to get to this point, right? Yeah, so he's laying on the ground. Yeah, nice. And then he like flies up. I love the reverse dying animation for him to get up. Oh. Cool. I even like how the dialogue continues running no matter where I go. Yeah. What is this? Is this like, are we watching Cops right now? Yay, it worked finally. Oh man, that was a long period of time to get all that working, but at least it's all good now. So this is great. I don't need this janky code, right? Which I had starting the player on the ground. Also, I've got flux types, so they pause. Like for example, you can't run a dialogue during a flux. So actually this code's ready to check in. Thanks, XY Storm. Yeah, this is the 208th day, I think, making this video game. Every one of the days of this game, you can see the development on YouTube. So if you go look at my YouTube channel, look at the info for this Twitch channel, you get all the details. And there's all these YouTube videos you can watch and soak up all this whole game's development if you want to see it. Noel, what's up, man? What's up? This is Xcode. This is what this IDE is. It's called Xcode. It's a really nice IDE for Macs. But this game is cross-platform. I'm using the game engine called Cocos 2DX. So this game's coming out for Windows, Mac, and Linux at first. And that's coming out on Steam in sometime between January and March. So I'll do my spiel really quick because this is about the end of today's stream. Let me check in this code first, though. And then I'll show you guys a little bit of the game stuff. So I'll check in these rock wake up. No, I don't need to check that in yet. But I should check that in. Yeah, it's for Linux too, totally. Cool. So what I've done today was added in some story for the home screen and added the ability to run animations from the story data. So this is a totally data-driven story player. Essentially plays out the story just based on some data in a file. Oh man, I keep having to redo this. No, you don't have to PayPal to donate. I'll show you in a sec. You can actually pre-order the game, and you get it out from Humble Bundle. How long have you been streaming today? 2 hours. Yeah, it's about my limit. I run out of energy about 2 hours, and that's what I'm feeling right now. So, take a little timer. Okay, so I can, oh yeah, I gotta check this stuff back out or undo this. Oops. And there's one thing here. Okay, now I can check in. And then I'll show you guys a little bit of the game. Yes, XY Storm, I stand. Cool, cool. So yeah, this whole system is great. I'm so glad to have this working now so I can do run these animations and stuff from the story data. So cool. Nice. Okay, so all right, let's do this. Yes, arcade games. I do continue developing all. So I develop for about 8 to 10 hours a day, 6 to 7 days a week, usually 7 days a week. Because I'm one guy. I have to work harder and longer because I'm only one person and I do all the art, I do all the music, I do all the code. So it takes a long time. Oh no, don't die, don't die. Okay, so I'm gonna run the game one more time and just show you guys a little bit because some people haven't even seen this game before. So, and I'll show you the menu too. So we can talk about pre-ordering because if anybody likes this game, if you wanna play a proceed, oh, that actually was broken there. He actually started standing up. Damn it, I thought he wasn't standing up at first. That's so funny. So anyways, yeah, if you like this game, it's a procedurally generated Zelda game. You can pre-order the game at songbringer.com. And by pre-ordering, you actually get your name as an honorary backer. So even though the Kickstarter is already over, you can still become an honorary backer and your name will be credited here in the main menu. So it costs $16 to pre-order this game. Your funds go towards me helping develop this game, and you get the game when it comes out, and you get some other stuff too. So if you check out songbringer.com, you can just see what else you get when you pre-order. But this is what the game is like. When you start a game, you enter your 6 letters, and it generates a whole world based on those 6 letters. So I'm just going to go back into this world I was playing already, Dingle. Ah. Well, that was weird. Player started at the bottom. Well, yep. So there's bugs. There's lots of bugs to work out of this game. But this is what it's like. It's like Zelda. Zelda 1, but it's procedural. And there's item crafting. So you can craft items together. Like this item I have right here. This is called the Fire Sword. This one here. It's flaming ghost sword or the fire sword or whatever, but you actually find this item called the ghost sword, and that's what enables you to shoot a projectile when you swing your sword. So it's a special item you find, right? And then you get to fire projectiles, and then later you can combine the ghost sword with the fire in a bottle, and the ghost sword plus fire equals the fire sword. So there's all this item crafting and stuff. Let me show you the item crafting place. So if you've killed all the enemies on a screen, you can actually warp back to your ship. Your ship is called Songbringer. That's the name of your ship. And back at your ship, you can craft items and combine stuff. So like if I wanted to combine my sword with the helmet or something. See, he doesn't like that. He's like, no, that's not the right combo. You can't combine those. But if that was the correct combo, he would do this whole item crafting combo thing for me. So this is the item crafter guy. So yeah, that's it for today's stream. I usually stream every day or sometime between 2 and 4 p.m. Pacific time. So, and I'll be back again tomorrow. And that's it. Thanks, Leonidas. Thanks, Vague Lines. See you guys.